offer me free land, no. Why you judge me at 35 ringgit per square feet? Yeah, they offer you free land. They offer you in the middle of the jungle, you take now. And you tell me, are you going to get your workers? When you're going to find human talent, you're going to bust them to and fro every day. At the end of the day, you look at it long term, not short term. Short term, yes, don't come to Penang. Long term, value for money in Penang. Clap lah. Buy, wow, cheaper, wow, discount here, discount there. But when they cannot get the human talent, when they cannot get the supply chain, when you do not have an existing ecosystem, and you, most important, you are talking to people who don't know what you're talking about. You talk to me, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I know all the linkages. I know whether you need fiber or broadband. I know what I'm talking about. I learned all these lessons in my first few years. Wow, study and build like mad. You know, I haven't been in government before. First time in government, stress out. Really stress out. But you learn the hard way. Steep learning curve, but we don't learn the hard way. And we know what we can offer and what we need to do to solve your problems. So first thing, and this is something I learned when I was doing my accountancy degree. Long term, always look at it long term. Long term, you must look at value creation. Don't be sucked in by those who are, you say they are value creation, but actually disguised as real value destroyers. Because there are a lot of value destroyers around. I'm not going to park for any particular project. I'm just talking about Penang generally. When I talk about industries, there are some people who are telling me, oh, your foreign direct investment dropped down. I said, excuse me, come again, your foreign direct investment go down. From 2010 to 2013, we are number one in Malaysia, you say our FDI dropped down. Then you get your figures. 3 years, we are number one. 20% of Malaysia's FDI. And who said it? Not Lim Guan Eng. Our Prime Minister, Datuk Sri Naji Tun Razak, replied in Parliament, Penang number one. Sometimes the figures can be massaged lah. You know lah how they do things lah. But take it from me, ask this important question: if it is so bad, why is it top companies are still coming to Penang? Top electronic firms. I'm not talking about second tier, third tier. Important they may be. Talking about top tier companies like Sandisk, companies like HP, companies like Bose. Companies like Seagate, a whole host of companies, they are still investing big time in Penang. Not in ringgit, in US dollars. Big time. And their companies are coming up. And this, of course, employment. Employment means they need houses to stay. So, what I want to stress is this. Is that, come to Penang and see for yourselves, whether the economy is doing well, whether there's prospect for further growth, whether we are doing the right things. And when you talk about, of course, the future, when you see Penang's future 10 years from now, 2025, what we are doing now is planting seeds. Seeds, especially in relation to human talent, high-tech industries, how to achieve conversions. I think that is what Penang's future lies. Penang's future lies in our ability to achieve conversions. If we can achieve convergence by 2025, you will see the birth of a new Penang. And what do you mean by convergence? Manufacturing sector, services sector, public sector. Convergence. And of course, some may be surprised. Why public sector? I say public sector very important. Because if you want to be a developed nation, your civil servants must be smart, must know what you are talking about. Because you can never be a developed or an international and intelligent city if your civil servants are not intelligent. And more of the success of Singapore is because your civil servants are up to mark. your civil servants are not up to mark. Apun. So civil service must also seek convergence with the manufacturing and services sector. And that's why we are focusing on the services sector, especially BPO, not just tourism. Tourism also has many branches, it's just only recreational, it's just only food, it's not just heritage, not just health tourism, not just education tourism, even though they are very important. You know, you have many Singaporean education institutions coming to Penang, SJI. They were set up, they've already set up, going to set up their school, SJI International School. And we hope to have the first world top 100 university in Malaysia in Penang. So at the moment, Malaysia doesn't have a top 100 world university. We hope to have the first one in Penang. So that will be in critical sector, but more important than that will be the services sector. You talk about financial services, you talk about data processing, you talk about shared services, outsourcing. This would establish Penang future. So if 2025 we can do it, then I think value creation will be here to stay. There will be no ghost towns, there will be busy satellite towns. And that's why it's important when we sign the joint venture agreement with Temasek. You Singaporeans drive very hard about it. When we signed the agreement, it was worth 11.3 billion ringgit. 49% Temasek, 51% Penang government. A JV to develop a Penang International Technology Park and also our BPO hub. Very hard bargaining, took years, but finally we did it. And I think the conclusion is simple. If your Temasek or confidence in Penang can sign with Penang, why are you all waiting for? Of course, they'll be doing a lot of commercial units, but it's going to be a 10-15 year project. But, you know, Temasek don't sign with just anyone. They don't sign with nobodies. They sign with people who think they can deliver, people they think they have confidence in. And most important, they can make some money lah. Or else they must have won Simon. So, I think I rest my case here. So if Temasek is coming in, for those, especially those SMEs, I know there are no SME people around here. We are hoping that SMEs, not only from Singapore, but all over the world, can look at Penang. Because we are going to use Temasek's network to try to source SMEs to come here, much as we want the multinational corporations which we do have in Penang. We think that the SMEs are the backbone of our industry and our economy. So we really would like to ask any SMEs around to probably consider Penang, and you can, don't talk to us, talk to Temasek. You don't have to come to Penang, go to your Singapore Temasek office, and then you can talk to the Temasek people, and perhaps, or EDs. Philip Yeo, you don't know Philip Yeo, isn't it? Anybody doesn't know Philip Yeo here? Oh, you don't know Philip Yeo, you're not Singaporean. Everybody knows Philip Yeo. So he's a very tough partner. He steals all my human talent. He come to Penang, have one lunch, you still don't know how many bright young stars from Chung Ling or Penang Free School or St. Xavier's start giving scholarship to Singapore University. I said, like that, mati lah. Don't have lunch with you anymore. So finally, we work out a deal, all right lah. Instead of brain drain, you have reverse brain drain. Come and invest in Penang, get the Penang Knights of Malaysians to work for Singapore companies in Penang. So you can meet them, you join them. But seriously speaking, I think we have much in common. Even though we are from different countries and different experiences, but we're all tied by blood. We have a lot of blood ties. We all share a lot of cultural traditions. We all enjoy good food. And of course, we share, I think, the same values. The values of good governance, the values of zero tolerance of corruption, values of having a livable city that is clean, green, safe and healthy. And you know, Penang is very safe. And the values of emphasis on human talent, and finally, of course, freedom. I think we are all born free, and we have right to live free. Thank you very much.